If you thought science was just found in textbooks, then you should meet the students at CASEE, who put on fishing waders and head out the on-site ponds in search of amphibians. 10th graders at CASEE, the Center for Agriculture, Science, Environmental Education in Battleground, Washington, trap, retrieve, and release amphibians as part of an ongoing regional scientific study. But first, they have to identify them.
So what do you think you got there?
A northwestern salamander.
Okay, why do you think so?
Because they don't have, like, dots.
Yeah, I don't see any dots high along the side. We're conducting a population study of our two ponds. Amphibians are bioindicators of their environment, and globally they have been declining.
Well, if you're looking at the traps, you can tell how many amphibians are left in the pond, and if you know how many amphibians are, you can get a general reading, say, how healthy the pond is.
10th graders study forestry, wildlife, environmental science, and English for half a day at CASEE. It's a great way for students to delve deep into scientific studies just outside their classroom door.
So what do you think you have here?
We have one caddisfly, and they make like these little houses out of debris from the ponds.
Today's students collect data on the presence of amphibians in CASEE's two ponds. They then analyze the data and compare it to past years. One big question students help answer is, how does the non-native bullfrog affect native amphibian populations?
Students also get an opportunity to work with scientists, which I think is an amazing opportunity and experience. They can ask somebody that is an expert in their field. They get to ask questions, they get to engage, they can make connections.
Hey guys, how's it going?
11 years ago, Charlie Crisafulli, a research ecologist for the U.S. Forest Service, assigned to study Mount St. Helens, was asked to develop a long-term study for CASEE students.
So I essentially lifted my scientific investigations at Mount St. Helens and superimposed it here at CASEE. So today the kids were continuing this project that's been going on for over a decade.
Does the snout seem broad?
Yeah, it looks pretty broad.
Yeah, so now we have two leads that would take us to the northwestern salamander.
What does the cloaca tell you about a salamander?
The gender.
Okay, that it's an adult, that it's breeding. So if it's swollen, I mean, it's going to be an adult.
Yeah.
It's more fun when you're out here, and I think you learn better when you're out doing it. You can hold the salamanders, it's easier to identify them. You know what it's like, and it's real.
So I'm going to be a veterinarian, so all this kind of like ties in like with the anatomy and then wildlife.
You can learn a lot of the stuff in the textbooks, but very rarely do you actually get the hands-on experience.
Situated on an 80-acre outdoor learning lab, students spend a half day on the CASEE campus and the other half of their day at their home high school to round out their studies. If you'd like more information about CASEE, visit our website and apply today, casey.battlegroundps.org.